Hey everyone, 84IronKnight here, back with another video review. This time of Transformers Universe Classics 2.0 Deluxe Class Galvatron. Now this is him in his Cybertronian tank mode, I'm assuming. The turret does rotate 360 degrees. It says Galv 25, Galv short for Galvatron. And 25, standing for the 25-year anniversary of Transformers, which was last year, 2009. Decent vehicle mode. Not a ton of paint apps. The most detail is actually right here on the turret, on the barrel here. The missile does fire. Hit that, and there it goes. So it launches pretty good. Limited up and down articulation. But other than that, no articulation. It has four wheels on the bottom. But the main highlight is the turret. Well, let's get to the transformation. I like to first start by popping off this turret. It actually makes it a little bit easier. And what you're going to do is you're going to grab each side here, pull it apart, and pull this up out, just like that, and rotate it back. Then you're going to take this back piece, pull that out, and then you're going to push this whole thing together. Rotate it around like that. Then you're going to rotate this piece around like that, and that'll be his hand. And then you're going to twist it around 180 degrees, and there's his right arm. Sorry, not his left, right. Okay, let's get to this. I like to start by pulling these apart here, pull them apart. Oh, not off. These pieces do like to pop off easy. Next thing you're going to do, untab it from here and here. Like that. Pull this up out of the way. Pull these down a bit. And then you're going to take this piece, fold these down a bit. Then you're going to rotate these. Well, not rotate them. You're going to kind of slide these in like that, and then fold these down, and they're just going to kind of tab into place. Next thing you want to do is rotate the waist around 180 degrees, like that. Okay. And you're going to rotate the knee around like that. Well, actually, the thigh, and then you're going to take the knee and rotate the knee around like that. Slide the foot down like that. And there are his legs. Okay. Next thing you want to do, this here, just kind of fold that in and push that down. It doesn't really snap into place anywhere. Then you're going to take this piece here, pull that around to the front, and then you're actually going to slot it right into place. Right. It should work. Oh. Okay. You're going to slot it from behind. Sorry. Go from behind, just like that. My bad. And then fold this down, fold that in, and then rotate. Actually, no, you don't got to rotate them, just fold them in, and they'll peg right into place. There's a peg here and a hole right there, and you can just kind of tab these into place. Next thing you're going to do is take the arm, fold it down, flip this piece up, rotate this around, fold it down, pull out his hand. And then if you want, there's this gray piece here. You can kind of, I don't know, flip that up. Doesn't really do anything. Doesn't really have any function. Then what you want to do is take this, push it up, and just kind of push it against the chest to lock it in place somewhat. Then we could take this arm and just peg it in right there, and there you have Galvatron in robot mode. Articulation, it's decent. Ball joint shoulder on the left arm, hinged elbow. This can rotate around. Other than that, really no movement. Swivel knee, hinge knee, hinge at the waist, a hinge at the thigh. So, I mean, he's got some decent articulation. The only problem is he's kind of back heavy, so he has a bit of a hard time standing up. As you'll see, you got to kind of position his legs awkwardly forward, so he can rest on these back pieces here for support. Big backpack on him. A lot of kibble on the back, which, you know, is what makes him so heavy. Very nice Decepticon symbol right there on the left arm. Very nice. Very detailed robot mode. I like the paint apps on the robot mode. They're pretty nice. Here's a close-up of his legs. Cannon. Which does still fire. Same button activates it. Overall, I mean, he's a lot of people don't like him. You know, I think he's alright. I mean, he's not the greatest Universe Classics figure in the lineup, but I think he's decent. I think the robot mode is pretty nice, although I don't like the amount of back kibble he's got, that big backpack, which doesn't really do anything. There is sort of a third mode, but it doesn't really make the figure any better, so I'm not really going to go into it. But my favorite thing on the figure, I love the Decepticon symbol right there on the left arm, but I love the head mold. That head sculpt is just amazing, and the orange light piping is a really nice touch to it. I like the chest piece, the stomach piece. I mean, the upper portion here is really what makes the figure stand out and kind of what makes up for some of the flaws in the rest of it.